Hey, Smarty fans, your pal Trusty has a gift for you. A 7-day free trial of Who Smarted Plus. That's right. If you sign up for Who Smarted Plus, you'll get 1 week of free access to all our subscriber episodes and bonus Smarty Cues, all ad-free. Parents, educators, and Smarty Pants have been letting us know how much they love their Who Smarted Plus subscriptions. Now's your chance to see what all the excitement is about. Again, this offer is 100% free. You can cancel anytime within the trial week. But I have a feeling you're going to want to stick around for all the exciting adventures and extra smarting. Sign up now right in Apple Podcasts or on whosmarted.com. Just click Join Who Smarted Plus. Thanks for smarting with us and supporting Who Smarted.
Psst, hey, Smarty Pants, listen up and see if you can guess where this music is from. Did you say The Lion King? I love me some Lion King. I saw the movie, the musical, and the remake. What about you? Do you love The Lion King too? I heard a lot of yeses. And what's not to like? Simba, Mufasa, Timon, Pumbaa, Hakuna Matata. But guess what? Did you know that The Lion King is based on a 400-year-old play written by a man named William Shakespeare? Speaking of playwrights, ever heard of Lin-Manuel Miranda? He wrote a little show called Hamilton. But guess what? Before Hamilton, Lin-Manuel Miranda wrote a hit play called In the Heights, which is based on another 400-year-old play, also by William Shakespeare. In fact, Shakespeare's work has inspired tons of movies and shows, like Game of Thrones, West Side Story, 10 Things I Hate About You, and Romeo and Juliet. Even episodes of Phineas and Ferb quote Shakespeare. Of course, Shakespeare can be a little challenging at first.
To be or not to be, that is the question? Actually, the question is, what the heck does that even mean? Mom!
What's wrong? Why are you still up? It's midnight.
I know, but I have like 100 pages of this super boring book to read by tomorrow, and I can't get through it.
What is it? Maybe I can help.
Shakespeare.
Nope, sorry. You're on your own with that.
And scene. Yep, Shakespeare's writing can be pretty intimidating, even for adults.
You can say that again. Shakespeare.
But don't worry. As your trusty narrator, I can help you better understand Shakespeare.
I wish Shakespeare included a trusty narrator to help explain his plays.
Oh, actually he did. Only Shakespeare called his narrator the chorus. It was a word the Greeks used for dialogue spoken directly to the audience that explains or narrates what's going on. Sort of like what I do on Who Smarted.
Shakespeare was Greek?
No.
But why did Shakespeare write everything so weird? It's all forsooth this and wherefore art thou that. How is anyone supposed to understand it?
I can help with that.
Can you help it be less boring?
Boring? Shakespeare's plays were the Marvel movies of his day.
Really?
Yep. And just like those Hollywood blockbusters, the work of Shakespeare is action-packed with witches, ghosts, magic spells, mistaken identities, reunited twins, overthrown kings, shipwrecks, epic storms, epic sword fights, weddings, funerals, even pie baking.
Ooh, like the Great British Bake Off?
Sort of. With Shakespeare, there's a little bit of something for everyone. But who is Shakespeare? Why do your teachers make you read his plays? And what does he have to do with classic movies like West Side Story and The Lion King?
I love The Lion King!
It's time for another whiff of science and history on
Who Smarted? Who Smarted? Who's smart? Is it you? Is it me? Is it science or history? Listen up, everyone. We make smarting lots of fun. But who's smarted?
Let's face it. No matter who you are or where you're from, someday you're going to have to deal with it. It could be an English class.
Okay, class, today we're going to be reading Macbeth.
Or for a class play.
Okay, actors, today we're performing Romeo and Juliet.
Or even on an exam.
To be or not to be? That is the question you need to answer for your essay.
Yep, at some point, you're going to encounter Shakespeare.
No!
What better way to take the fear out of Shakespeare than by talking to an expert? And what better expert on Shakespeare than the man himself? I'll just set this handy teleportation time machine to the year 1616. And the place, Stratford, England. And voila! Welcome to Who Smarted, Mr. Shakespeare.
Smarted? Smarted? What language doth thee speak?
English.
Thee calleth that English?
It's slang. And you're one to talk about strange-sounding English.
I am confused. Whither am I?
You're in the future. I sent for you to help teach my smarty pants friends about you and to explain the odd way you speak and write.
Oh, speak the speech, I pray you, as I pronounced it to you trippingly on the tongue.
Yeah, see, when you talk like that, people today find it kind of...
brilliant? Poetic? Effervescent?
Hard to understand.
Well, I think it's poetic.
It is, but also hard to understand. But that's okay. Here, do me a favor and put this on.
What is this ghastly contraption? Wherefore must I wear it?
Trust me, just slip it onto your head like a crown. And now I'll just flip the switch. Okay, say something.
What do you want me to say? This thing's heavy. It's like squishing my head. Whoa. What's happening? Why do my words sound all funny?
It worked. Look, no offense, Willie, but many people are scared to even approach your plays because your characters talk so old-fashioned. So I had my nephew make this translator, and with the flip of a switch, we can easily understand anything you or your character say.
Wow, that's cray-cray.
Uh-huh. And if I flip it back to the 1600s...
Oh, wonder. Oh, brave new world that hath such inventions.
Yeah, let's keep it on 2021.
I must admit, that's pretty cool, dude.
Thanks. So, tell us a little about yourself.
Well, I was born and raised in a small town in England called Stratford-upon-Avon. That just means the town of Stratford was near a river named Avon. I was the third of eight children and studied at the local grammar school where I learned how to read and write in English and Latin. When I was 18, I married the beautiful Anne Hathaway.
Oh, from The Princess Diaries and The Devil Wears Prada.
The devil does what now?
Never mind. Continue.
Anne and I had three kids. Susanna, our oldest, and the twins, Judith and Hamnet.
Hamnet? Sounds kind of like your famous play, Hamlet.
Are you going to keep interrupting?
Sorry.
When our kids were young, we struggled for money, so I started writing poems and eventually plays to sell. I even acted in a few with the local theater troupe, the Lord Chamberlain's Men. At first, I wrote mostly comedies with broad jokes everyone loves. Or plays about old kings and queens filled with sword fights and battle scenes.
Well, like I said, you're the original Marvel movies.
And I marvel at how effortlessly you keep butting in.
Continue.
Eventually, I grew weary of writing such light and silly things. I began writing darker plays about life and death, fate and love and revenge. Things like Romeo and Juliet, Hamlet, King Lear, and Othello.
Oh, how many of those plays have you heard of, Smarty Pants?
I eventually retired around the time the theater burned down.
The theater burned down?
Yeah, we never should have used real candles in Henry VIII. The entire roof was made of straw. Oopsie.
Do you have any idea why your plays were so popular then and continue to be so popular now?
Honestly, no.
No?
I mean, they were fine. I definitely had some good moments. To be or not to be, now is the winter of our discontent, brevity is the soul of wit. Those are some classic lines that have stood the test of time. But I had a lot of clunkers, too. Timon of Athens is pretty meh.
Yeah, and Titus Andronicus was pretty violent.
Was it?
You had the lead character, Titus, bake Tamora's sons into a pie, and then he served it to her as punishment for the crime she committed.
Oof, that is nothing like the British Bake Off.
Yeah, I sometimes went too far. Double oopsie.
Hey, Willie, let's play a little game to show my smarty pants friends how to make sense of the Elizabethan language in your plays.
Games? I love games. When do we start?
Right after this quick break. Now back to Who's Smarted. Okay, I'm here with William Shakespeare, and we're going to play a game. First, I'm going to flip the translation switch back to 1600. Then I have him say a famous line from one of his plays. Then it's up to everyone listening to try and guess what it means.
Let's do it.
Let's start with a famous line from Romeo and Juliet.
But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun.
Okay, smarty pants. What do you think that line means? Is it A, yo, who broke my window? Was it Juliet's son? B, hey, Juliet, this yellow window makes you look just like the sun. Or C, whoa, what's shining so brightly through that window? Why, it's Juliet, looking more beautiful than the sun. Got your answer? Let's find out.
Whoa, what's shining so brightly through that window? Why, it's Juliet, looking more beautiful than the sun.
Did you get it right? Don't worry if you didn't. Understanding Shakespeare takes time and practice, but once you get the hang of it, it's like riding a bike. Let's try another. This one's from Hamlet. In this scene, a dad gives his son advice before leaving on a long trip. All right, Shakespeare, hit it.
This above all, to thine own self be true, and it must follow as the night the day, thou canst not then be false to any man.
Okay, that's a lot, so we'll give you only two choices. Does it mean A, look above you, that's where the truth lies, like night and day are above you, so don't lie to anyone because it's not cool? Or B, the most important thing is to be true and honest to yourself. If you do that, just as it's true that night follows day, you will never do anyone wrong. Did you say B? Nice. The important thing to remember about Shakespeare is that while the words may seem old-fashioned, everything the characters talk about are things people think and feel today. That's why his stories have been turned into modern movies and musicals like The Lion King, where a young prince's father is murdered by his uncle, causing the prince to run away, until he's visited by his father's ghost, who tells him to face his uncle and avenge his death.
Hey, just like my play, Hamlet.
Or the musical West Side Story about a boy and girl from rival families who fall in love.
Just like in Romeo and Juliet.
Precisely.
Oof, I really should have copyrighted my plays. I would have made a fortune on all these adaptations.
True, but it's also great you didn't, because now anyone can be inspired by your work to write their own stories about love, war, or injustice. The world is their oyster.
Hey, I wrote that line in The Merry Wives of Windsor.
You sure did. But now it's time to say goodbye.
Parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say goodnight till it be morrow. Later, dude.
A big shout out to Superfan Noah in Camden, Maine. Thanks so much for listening to Who Smarted? This episode, Shakespeare, was written by Jason Williams and voiced by Imogen Williams, Charlotte Cohn, Jason Williams, and Jerry Colbert. Technical direction and sound design by Josh Hahn. Who Smarted is recorded and mixed at the Relic Room Studios. Our associate producer is Max Kamaski. The theme song is by Brian Suarez, with lyrics written and performed by Adam Tex Davis. Who Smarted was created and produced by Adam Tex Davis and Jerry Colbert. This is an Atomic Entertainment production.